Bass up full blast, play it all night long.
This video is just a reference pretty much for your audio and making sure that you have good sound with your mic and your laptop. And with so many people working remotely and from home these days and so many videos out there, one still hears quite a bit of audio that's kind of tough to listen to. And I think that if the audio is not good, it's hard to even listen to a video or be on a video conferencing call. One can sit through pretty marginal video work and camera work, but it's hard to sit through poor audio. People have been using mics with their laptops for years. I mean, back to the desktop days. It's a good idea just to go through some of the sound settings and the app settings for apps that use voice like Zoom conferencing and OBS. And I just want to go through the settings within Windows. In Apple, it would probably be about the same. There's so many videos on audio out there, on positioning of the mic, which is important, and the acoustics of the room. And this is more just to how to configure your laptop to make sure that you're using the mic and have the right levels and using the mic as your sound card, if you like. For this video, I'm going to use a common mic that's pretty good quality, even though it's not that expensive. It's a Samson Q2U, and it has interconnectability to both an audio interface through XLR, and it has direct connectability with USB. So we're going to use it as a USB mic. The research that I've seen on this mic says that whether you use it directly into the laptop as a USB mic or using it with an audio interface, that the quality of the sound is similar. For simplicity purposes, we're going to use the mic USB connected directly to the laptop. Like I say, with Apple, it's a similar type of thing. Okay, let's start off by looking at the mic. Here's the mic. So this is the mic. Of course, you got to make sure it's on. At the bottom here, we have volume, and that's really for your computer volume if you're using the mic as a sound card. This is the connection here. That's the XLR connector at the bottom, the round one, and that's for using an audio interface. But then you see the USB connector, headphone connector right there, and that's about it. Just having a little stand or whatever. I mean, this is really for people who maybe don't want to use a headset and people that are on a lot of calls for video conferencing. You'll see all kinds of videos like on using filters, like pop filters for plosives, for P's that they don't make, you know, when you make the P sound and things like that. And, you know, this is like this could go over the mic, something like this, you know, or this something. This is a wind type of filter, I guess, but I'll use them sometimes as well. And I'm using a different mic. This one's got a filter on it. That mic I just showed you, this Movo, it's a condenser mic. So it's very sensitive and it picks up a lot, really. You're better off for like conferencing calls, you know, video conferencing and whatnot, in a house or a place where there may be noises, other noises in the house, even little noises, to use like a dynamic mic like this Samson that we talked about, right? This one is better for that. And that's a dynamic. It doesn't pick up as much sound around it. The one that I'm using does. It's very sensitive. And so anyway, that's why that's better, really, and especially in a house. The thing is you need to speak into it about like this, you know, pretty close, you know, at a little bit of an angle. But there's so many videos on mic positioning. That makes a big difference. The other thing, too, I'll just say this, even though I'm not going to get into it in any depth, is the room acoustics does matter, too. I mean, it'll sound very echoey if you don't have, like, at least like some carpeting on the floor, especially if they're like certain types of wood floors and certain types of vinyl. And also, like, if you have flat surfaces like the wall, or there's not much couch or furniture in the room, it will bounce off the walls pretty badly. So the thing that I do is I just use heavy moving blankets. And I put them like, I hang them kind of near the wall without being too invasive into the house or to my office. I'll just hang them. You can make the room a little more acoustic by putting some things around to where it's not
where the sound's not banging right off the flat walls. That's just that. Those are things, like I say, there's thousands of videos on them. It would probably be a good idea to take a look at that. So anyway, back to what this is really about. So if you go down here to the tray, the Windows tray, right, and you right click on the speaker, right, you can go to sounds here. Okay. So the playback is the sound coming out of the laptop. Okay. And I just have it set up right now as the default. I don't have the mic. Let's say the mic's not plugged in yet. Okay. So this is the sound coming out of the laptop, right? Hearing the other people. And then this is the recording is the mic. So it's picking up right now. As you can see, it's picking up, you know, right off the laptop. Actually, this is the laptop default mic that comes with. Okay. I checked the quality of that just for laughs, and it is horrible, you know, and I compared it to, you know, to using the Samson mic. It's, you know, it's unbelievably different. For those that don't have this sound icon in their tray, you know, just go over here to the start for Windows and just put sound settings. And then go over here to sound control panel, and that'll show you what's configured in Windows. That's all it is. Okay, here's playback. That's coming out of your speakers on your laptop. And here's recording. Recording is your mic. Okay, so that's the default mic. Okay, so let me go back to the tray, because that's probably where everyone's going to use. Again, I don't mind coming in and out of these, because it'll probably just be good as a reference, you know. Sometimes people don't feel comfortable of what mic they're using. They're not comfortable what levels they're at, and they're just, you know, using external mics. I know people have used them for literally decades, you know, with laptops. As long as laptops and desktops have been around, people have used mics. It's not that big a deal. So let's go back to the icon, right click on it, right, and go into sounds. Okay, so now I'm going to plug in the mic, the USB mic, directly natively, and there it is. Okay, so I'll right click on this and I'll enable it, and then it just becomes the default device. This is the mic. I'm using it as a sound card for playback. You really don't have to do that, right? You could still use the mic. You could disable this, right? And now the speakers that you'll be using are your headphones plugged into your laptop. If you make this your sound card, plugging your speakers into the back of this or your headphone into the back of this mic, then you will be hearing everything coming from the computer through the mic. I'll keep the internal speakers enabled just in case something happened to the mic. Let's say it got unplugged or whatever. At least you'd hear something coming out. And then we'll keep this as the default, as if we're going to use it as the sound card. Here's the business portion of the mic, right? So here's the microphone. As soon as you plug it in, it becomes enabled, right, as the default. But I would check that, right? And this one I'll go ahead and disable, I think. I don't think I want the other mic enabled, right? We'll use this mic. But using the same logic, if you wanted to keep it enabled, you could, because if something happened to the mic, you still have a mic, you know, going. It's up to you. I say okay. Now we can go here back to this, or go to your Windows command and enter the sound, and you'll go right to this, right? And we'll go to sound settings. We kept this one enabled, the internal, but here's the speakers, right? Going to the, so we're using the mic as the sound card. I didn't keep the internal mic enabled. Okay. So now pick up the Samson, talking to it. And there's our level. The mic, as you can see, as I talk into this, I'm using another mic to record this, but that just shows you that it's working. And this can apply to if you're going to use an audio interface too. Everything's the same. You just plug the audio interface into the USB and then you plug mics into it. Okay. But that's not the intent of this. I mean, I have other videos on using, you know, audio interfaces with 8 channels and things like that. And there's like thousands and thousands of videos out there on that. We're using the mic for everything. So if you wanted to hear the sound, you plug your speakers into it or your headphones. If you don't have speakers or headphones, then you almost have to use your laptop because it's got speakers built in, right? So then you'd go back, and if that were the case and you still want to use the mic, right, you just go back here and you go to sounds, right? And then you just go to playback, and then you make this the default. You go here, you disable it, the mic, and then you go here, and this will become, if you disable this, that becomes the default device. Now, let's go into, like, this is OBS. This is a pretty popular program, too. Many people might be familiar with it as well. This is a, you know, screen capturing type program. This is the mic, right? And this will be for any app. When I go on this call, I know I'm going to have sound. I'm going to have my mic working and all that type of stuff. Okay? So, this is really bare bones. But, so you go into here, right? On this app, you go into this, into the settings, you go to properties, right? And here it is. It's set up. I disabled the internal mic for the laptop in Windows. The only choice you get is this mic. Okay, but you still want to make sure that it's set up. And now I'm going to pick up the mic. Here's where you can deal with the levels, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you know, you put the level that you want for the app. You know, you don't want to get into the red. I think people know this stuff, but anyway, so now if we were going to use this app, right? And you're going to, let's say you wanted to stream, you could stream with that. You could stream with OBS or whatever, record something. You know, you're set up using that mic. Okay. Just that simple. And let's go to Zoom settings. And here it's going to default. I mean, you know, Windows figures this out, you know? So here we go. I got the mic and I'm doing my levels right now and it looks pretty good. So you can see that you're getting decent levels right here. And you can test the mic. You click the button and listen to the sound coming back. It'll tell you, you know, how you sound, and you're done. So you do that with every app, and that's it. I mean, you know, it really isn't much more to it. I would have recommended just using an audio interface for this, but I watch videos where they compare the native USB mic to an audio interface using the same mic with XLR connection. In other words, connecting the mic to the audio interface and the audio interface to the USB on your laptop. And the sound of the mic either way sounded just as good. So if you don't really want to get into audio to any great degree, then just plug in one of these mics and go, one of these dynamic mics like this that's a USB mic. The mic location next to your mouth and things like that, and not bumping it and having maybe a pop filter on it and a little bit of padding in the room, you know, without being too invasive into the room would be good, but that's probably all you need. I know a lot of people use headsets, but some people don't want to use them, you know, and then there's Bluetooth headsets and all that type of stuff, you know, and that makes sense too, because you can get up and go to the bathroom while you're on a call, you know, as long as you got a muting and stuff. So that's it. A very basic topic, just Windows sound type stuff that might help somebody that's just starting out. Maybe suddenly they're in a position where they have to do video conferencing calls and they're not that comfortable making sure that when they enter the call that they're producing, you know, good sound. It should help a little bit.
Sweet home Alabama, sing that dead band song. Turn them speakers up full blast, play it on.